Some were destroyed in battle. Others weren't completed. Some are laid up and can only dream about battles. But now, they're getting a new lease of life. We recreate ships accurately, according to their historical blueprints, and send them into battle. World of Warships, Dry Dock.
During World War I, the Baltic Fleet of the Russian Empire lacked contemporary light cruisers to fulfill the tasks of destroying enemy destroyers and supporting Allied ones, conducting reconnaissance for battleship forces, and laying mines in hostile waters. The Russian High Naval Command decided to explore the possibility of using large destroyers armed with incredibly powerful artillery to fill this role, as such ships could be built more quickly and cheaply. A salvo from one of these destroyers could be compared to a broadside salvo from one of these Svetlana-class light cruisers. In the spring of 1917, a draft design for such a ship was created under the supervision of renowned naval engineer Colonel Rostislav Matrosov. The ship was essentially a variant of destroyer Gavriil, but with greater length. Gavriil was the most advanced ship of the Novik class in the Baltic Fleet. It was planned for the project to have a displacement of 2,100 tons, while her two turbines, capable of producing 35,200 horsepower, would have allowed for speeds of up to 33 to 34 knots. The ship's artillery armament comprised 8 130mm guns, 2 76.2mm anti-aircraft guns, and a couple of 7.62mm machine guns. Her torpedo armament comprised 3 450mm triple torpedo launchers. A fourth launcher could also replace one of her main battery guns if desired. The upper deck could house up to 300 mines. The project by Matrosov was quite an original attempt to create a multi-purpose light warship that could also be deployed as a fast mine-laying ship and that was equipped with powerful artillery and torpedo armament. History recalls a phrase spoken by the chairman of the technical council at the head shipbuilding department that vividly described the future ship. "Colonel, you're suggesting us to build a killer." However, the project was never approved due to serious doubts about whether it would have been possible to achieve the projected speed without increasing the power and propulsion weight, which would have led to a further increase in the ship's displacement. In World of Warships, the project by naval engineer Rostislav Matrosov has finally been embodied in the form of Promo-Soviet Tier 5 premium destroyer, Ochotnik.